No! No, no, you're putting terrible pressure on us to be good.
Yeah. If it's shit now, you'll feel bad, we'll feel bad.
Yeah.
Anyway.
Oh, blimey.
It's my ex-wife.
Yeah.
I'd recognise that voice anyway. Yeah. And, you know, hairy chest all the way down to a bollock.
Oh, yeah.
What? Everybody clapped except that bloke.
Which one? That one there?
That one in, like, grey sleeves and black.
Well, he might be paralysed from the hands up.
From the hands up?
I'm not sure that quite works.
If he'd been paralysed from the hands up, he could have done that. Was that some bank robbery accident? The hands up. Help, I'm paralysed. What about if you got paralysed like that, though? That would be terrible, wouldn't it?
Well, it'd be useful in some circumstances.
If you were taking a corner?
Yeah, if you're taking a corner. Yeah.
I don't know why they do that.
Sometimes they do that as well.
Not but for a corner, do they?
Yeah, sometimes.
That's German players. Because it's very... If you were paralysed like that, it'd be useful for getting your jumpers on and off.
Yeah, and for deodorising.
Yeah.
Be useful for deodorising.
Obviously, you'd need a cooperative partner.
Yeah, someone who's happy to deodorise.
Yeah.
And they wouldn't be happy about much else in your life. Because you'd never do the washing up, for example, unless you had a very high sink.
Well, you could kneel.
That's true.
Morning, love. Come over and I'll just squeeze your tits.
Good bit of tit squeezing there, I must say. Excellent.
That's how
Jim Davidson squeezing someone's tits.
That's how I squeeze tits. I don't, none of this gentle caressing. I just slightly feel the weight stop.
Yeah. Is there a noise? It feels like there should be a noise accompanying it, like whack, whack, whack.
I have sometimes, I've done that as a bit of a comedy thing.
Have you?
I have. I've put my hand down and gone,
You've done a sort of Model T Ford noise.
And there's one when it's sort of like a broke, you go, huh? Try it.
I will do.
I love it. They love it. That's what they expect from comedians, these women.
So.
Red nose on the end of the penis, that worries them. They think it's
comic relief.
Yeah. Red nose, yeah, with any luck. Yeah. Now red nose on the end of the penis and
Shepherd's delight.
They think I'm offering them a match.
Yeah. I see your tailor's in.
Yeah. Biggest tear of the night for my shirt. I call it salmon. Mm. What would you call it?
Pink. Pink. It's pink. It's a very gay shirt, isn't it?
In what way is it a gay shirt?
It's pink.
Easily liftable.
Yeah. It is very easily liftable.
Yeah.
It's got so... Are you what? Quality watch.
If you remember...
What's going on? Have people got telescopes and things? Every part of you.
Yes. I feel I'm being dissected.
You are. Actually, I'd say the watch clashes...
Oh, you're going to fucking start now.
I would say the watch clashes with the shirt, actually.
I wouldn't say it clashed. I'd say that it bled into the watch.
You think? I think it clashes. You are gay.
Yeah. What are we? Yeah. Actually, I meant to throw that Clayfield over the top. He hit the board like a fucking banger, didn't he?
What's happened to your watch?
Where have you put that fucking watch?
Look, can you just give him your watch?
Well, I'm not happy. I'm not happy.
Just
thanks.
So you know
I'll wear this
is.
One.
Okay.
So, thank you very much for that. What do you think?
That's quite nice, actually.
Yeah.
It's worth about five times your watch as well.
Is it self-winding? Yeah, I'll wear it on this one so I don't overwind. Sit down. Anyway, it's a bit of a start. Have you got a question to ask Blondie?
I was going to ask you if I could have your watch, because I've just been on holiday and I lost my watch.
Of course you can have my watch.
If we could streak at a major event, what major event would we streak at? Yeah. I know, I was repeating it, mate, because you haven't got a fucking microphone. Miss World, I think. Because you never know your luck.
Yeah.
They might just think, oh, fucking hell.
Oh, well, fucking hell, it's Miss Greece. Anyway, is there anyone who has never seen the show on telly or anything and doesn't know what to expect tonight at all? Yeah? There's one person, yeah, thanks. One, a bloke with a... Is it a bloke with a shaved head or is it Sinead O'Connor?
Thank you.
You've never seen the show ever?
No.
No? Okay. So were you, what, expecting Les Miserables or...? No, yeah. You haven't seen the show, because in fact, I'm not going to make it a respect from you, but you are the girlfriend of my personal trainer, aren't you?
Yeah.
Yeah, my personal trainer is in town. Can you believe I've got a fucking personal trainer?
What a
fucking sue you.
Look at that.
Two years in the gym.
I should get, get your business cards out, they'll be queuing up.
Sorry, Steve.
That's all right.
Sorry, mate. But, you know, you make me sweat on that fucking bike.
You better wait.
Well, so don't talk about it like that.
Now, is there a distant crow in the...
Yeah.
A seagull.
Yeah. Someone sneaked. Oh. What?
Turning into a mouse now, it's that just all animals.
It reminds me when I was in the army, I had someone fucking a macaw. Right. That's what it sounds
like.
You
were in the army?
I was in the army, yeah. Salvation.
Oh, right.
It was the brass that attracted me.
Was it? Is that a French horn?
No, I always sit like this.
Hurrah!
Musical! So why has your personal trainer's girlfriend never seen the show?
Because they don't have a TV.
You don't have a TV? Where do you live? Well, when you get to the gym and people say, yo, fucking hell, eh? EastEnders last night. What are you talking about? Yeah, but one of our goldfish went right the way. One of them with the little string of pearls.
Yeah, goldfish do have that.
They have that's like a... You know when you it's see... In porn films, sometimes you see these anal beads that people...
Oh! Oh, the glasses are coming off!
And they put...
Anal beads?
Yeah, they have like a string of about 7 or 8 beads, and they put it up their bum, one at a time.
Yes, I was pretending to be shocked. I know exactly what they are.
You're pulling I know you do. In fact, wasn't it only last Christmas?
Anyway. Get your hand off my fucking knee.
Okay. And you pull them out, always with that jolting movement, where they're inclined to cling.
They are.
And
there's a bit, there's sort of noise, isn't there, when they come out. A sort of suction noise.
Yes. Anyway, we don't have Dolby. But you can't. So I like women with shaved heads. I think that's, you know, there was one in, remember the first Star Trek film had got a...
No, she hasn't got a telly.
Did you actually call your boyfriend the other half there? Are you from the 1960s?
No, please. Leave it, she's a Siamese twin.
Is there a doctor in the house?
Someone, a doctor, not a silly twat.
There's someone dressed as a nurse.
A nurse. It's a bloke. So you're a bloke dressed as a nurse. Hello, you're doing rag week, aren't you?
Yes.
If you're doing rag week, don't wear a white dress. That's my advice. Yeah. Is it a special event tonight? Some kind?
It's my stag do.
Oh, it's your stag do?
Yeah.
What's your name?
Tim.
Tim. And when do you get married, Tim?
2nd of June.
Just got out of your mind for a second there.
Tough question.
It's going well, the stag night, isn't it? That's right.
Actually, I think we should have Tim as our secretary. Yeah! Oh. Oh my God.
That was so lovely.
Do you know, he's got a red nose on the end of it. Did the lady's outfit not extend to the shoes then, or
sorry,
what?
Cheapskates. The rest of the party couldn't afford the rest.
Right.
These are really nice, aren't they?
Well, they're quite feminine for nurses' shoes, actually.
Lovely.
In fact, those are quite on hairy legs for a nurse as well.
I love the way that the
E.T. Tiger
hair on a hairy leg.
Sorry. Oh, I miss that.
He said E.T. Tiger, Frank. What's the name of your intended, Tim?
Libby.
Libby, right.
And she's mad.
She's mad? She fucking must be, Tim.
Is she on at hen night tonight?
She is, yeah.
Where is she, do you know?
She's at a vanna at the moment.
Is she dressed as a bloke?
Square.
She's in a vanna?
Yeah.
She's in a vanna?
Yeah.
Well, smoking a cigar? Dressed as a bloke?
Yeah. Well, one hopes so, yeah.
Yeah, just a cigar, we hope.
Yeah. Easy Tiger.
Yeah. Tim's got a fucking catchphrase.
Yeah.
Incredible.
15 years in the business, I've never come up with one. Tim's got one like that. How old are you, Sarah?
16.
16?
And you're wearing a... I can tell the audience are thinking that the phrase just legal is somewhere in our minds. But they're wrong about that, aren't they?
If you do come up to the dressing room, you must bring a photocopy of your birth certificate. I'm not risking that again.
You're wearing a T-shirt, I don't know if you want to see that, says, "Oh my God, I'm starting to sound like my mother." Is that the case? Are you?
Sometimes, it's kind of worrying.
You're starting to sound like your mother? Mm. Your mother's only about 32.
Yeah. Just so it turns out, I know what your mother sounds like. And I'll be the judge of whether you're starting to sound like it. No, I'm joking. Is there a particular phrase that you can think of that you've said that your mother might say?
Not really.
Don't do it to me, Frank. This is Darren, who plays George Dawes in New Zealand.
Wait for it. Get the instructs. Please sit down. You're a fucking big lad, aren't you? Do you play rugby, by any chance?
Sometimes.
I thought you might. Have you ever been to Twickenham?
Once or twice.
Yeah. You know, there's a big sign over the door at Twickenham that says, "Rugby, a cunt's game." I wrote that. Okay. So anyway, welcome. Do you live in England, or...?
Now I do, yes.
You do?
Yes.
Okay. And what do you do for a living?
A housewife.
Hang on, Frank, give him a microphone.
No, hold it.
Give him the microphone.
Oh, I forgot that.
You've got a fucking microphone.
Got mixed up. For a minute there, I thought I was Kilroy.
I like the woolen kind of tank top thing, because it's the sort of thing that I imagine is worn by evacuees. You know, with big grey shorts during the Blitz.
Of course I remember, I was fucking there.
Yeah, I know you were.
Well, I wouldn't know, but it's quite trendy.
I'm sure it is. I'm sure it's very trendy.
Are you sure?
I certainly am.
You sure that... Is that what the market stall holder told you?
That's what I told me.
Okay, fair enough. You didn't knit it yourself?
Certainly didn't.
How do you knit that? Because look at that, there's about...
She doesn't knit.
No, but someone fucking did.
That'd be French Connection.
French Connection knitted it.
Yeah, but French Connection hire old ladies who knit them. Obviously.
Oh, I see.
You can smell the urine on a hot day.
Good.
You can.
And what
French Connection.
When were you 16?
March.
In March?
Yeah.
Okay.
March?
Yes, in March.
Yeah. That's very recently, isn't it?
It is very recent. Even Bill Wyman. Give it 20 minutes, will you? Oh, my God.
Awful, isn't it?
It looked like one of those piles of dead animals.
Shall we set fire to it?
Let's not set fire.
What do you do, Debbie, for a living?
I'm a pupil barrister.
A pupil barrister? What, you take eyes and you take them to court?
What, in the eye court? Marvellous.
I play music. I play piano, clarinet and bassoon.
You play the piano?
Yeah.
I do that as well. Have you ever seen me do it? Do you think I'm good?
Yeah.
What's that?
Yeah.
What do you play? What sort of stuff
what grade
do you
play? Are you?
I took my grade 8.
Oh, you're better than me.
Yeah. She's only bloody 16.
I know. I took my grade 7 and I failed it. I was a punk. At the time, I'd just become a punk rocker. Right? I was a little sort of nerdy Jew, and I thought I shouldn't be playing classical music. I should be a fucking punk rocker. So I became a punk rocker, and then deliberately failed my grade 7.
Yeah, sure you did. Yeah, like I deliberately failed my first 9 driving tests. What kind of thing do you play classical music?
Yeah.
Like, who's your favourite?
Haydn.
Haydn?
Yeah.
Well, I don't know about you. I wouldn't mind hearing a bit of Haydn.
What, now?
Yeah. Is it all right with you? Can play a bit, yeah. No, she's very confident. This
you're
could
right
be a
with
big
that, you're right with this, Sarah. You don't mind.
Yeah, go for it, Sarah.
All right. You know, and also...
I tell you what would be particularly good if you could play a bit of Haydn and Frank could sing along to it.
Off you go.
What do we do with the drunken sailor? Now, what you have to do is, I know not easy for a rugby player, you have to write basically the topics that we cover in the thing so far, which right. So far is nothing.
Pretty much.
But it'll come up, won't it? And if, to make yourself feel at home, at any stage, you want to go... That's fine.
But what was that thing you were doing the other day that you think that barristers do? What was it that?
Do you think they do that?
Do you do that? Because you've got the tank top for it.
Well, they do that, though. Oh, so that's when they're getting smarmy during the summing up. And they go, well, it's all very well. To Tessa say that you had voices in your head saying, kill all prostitutes. But we all do.
Have we found out what you do for a living, Darren?
Yeah, I'm a house father.
You're a house father? What, you've given birth to a house?
A very small one.
Yeah. Was it by any chance a brick-built shit house?
Close.
Yeah.
What?
I can't help thinking of anyone in court without thinking of those terrible courts adverts and Bruce Forsyth. Saying silencing courts.
Silencing courts, yeah.
Fantastic. Nice to see you. So what we do is we take a series... Sorry, did you...
No, I just wondered if that was Bruce Forsyth after a stroke, is what it looked like.
God, that would be terrible. Because the silhouette at the back of the stage would be like that.
And then he couldn't get out of it.
Yeah.
And he'd say, It'll be Death is the name of the game.
Oh, no. That's cruel. It'll be called the Degeneration Game. Yeah. I hope that doesn't happen. I love Bruce.
Yeah, I love Bruce as well.
And he'd say, nice to see you, but I can't! Do you remember Maria Whittaker, the page three girl? Very big
tits.
Yeah. I'm trying to keep it clean, but you know, she was busty. And I was at this this launch for some BT rubbish, and she was the like, one of the other celebs, and she was...
You have to do this all the time.
I visualise it. She does it. She actually holds them up like that.
Yeah. Really? You'd think you get some kind of hands-free item for that.
Yeah.
Called a bra.
Oh, of course. So, she was orange. Totally orange.
I thought
orange.
You said it was a BT thing.
So if anyone does have a question, then we'd be happy to listen to it. Oh, that lady there stuck her hand up and then immediately put it down again.
Can I just say, that was a brilliant piece of hand raising because she just went.
Are you bidding for both of us or what?
It was like that. I bought Elvis's shirt once, this shirt that Elvis has had. And when I bid it for the first time round, I went like this. It was like £1,000. And then the next time I went. And by the end of it, I was going. I was trying to see how small I could make. It was just like the wind had just caught one of my eyelashes. What about that lady in the white shirt over
Hello.
There? Hello.
Yeah, that got a big laugh,
honestly. Isn't
it? Have you ever been on a date or with your girlfriend and seen another lady that you fancied and asked for her phone number?
I'm not going to fucking admit that, am I?
But it could be an ex, you know, it could have happened in the past.
Yes. I haven't actually, to be honest. I've never done it, but I bet you fuck it off.
I don't remember a phone number, I've managed to squeeze a blowjob in.
It'd have to be a blowjob, really, because if you just snogged them and went for a feel, they'd hear you, because you'd be going, whack, 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 whack.
The secret is you say to the girlfriend, is that your car alarm? Just gives me time to get a quick one in, I find.
Are you a sex machine, eh?
Easy tiger.
Yeah.
When did you decide to cut your hair, David?
You did dye your hair, didn't you? No, you've let it go.
Oh, tell everybody about it, don't you? I see. No, well, she's going to write that down now. I did dye it for a bit, but now I've let the grey come out, I think I'm all right with it now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But the beard looks darker than the hair, which is
that's because I'm still fucking dyeing the beard, all right.
Well, you're weaning yourself off it gradually.
Yeah. Well, the thing is, I think...
You're just going to dye the moustache eventually.
I think the grey hair in a beard makes you look a bit like a tramp, because it could be mistaken for bits of milk. And other
I've
food
never
stuff.
Ever met a tramp who drank milk.
Well, that's true. All right. It could be mistaken for bits of Baileys.
How fucking posh an area do you live in where the fucking tramps drink Baileys? It was. Excuse me, but does one have 10 pence for a cup of tea? Ah, oh, dear. Did I tell you a tramp came up to me on New Street Station and said...
I think you did, but tell me again.
I loved it. This is what they call a moral dilemma. I was on New Street Station in Birmingham years ago, and a tramp came up to me and said, oh, could I have a bite of your burger? I either had to give him the whole burger or run off.
Run off with the burger.
Well, imagine saying, yeah, have a go. Oh, thanks very much. And when it comes back, there's like more bread on it than there was when you had it.
Oh, dear. Very unusual for them to want food instead of drink.
Well, I don't know. What they
was this when you were drinking?
No.
When this happened?
Yeah.
Are you sure you didn't have some Thunderbird with you that he was going to snatch while you were giving him the burger?
Oh, I actually had Thunderbirds with me.
Did you?
Yeah.
Which ones?
I had brains.
Did you? Yeah. You could eat them, of course.
I had the hood.
The hood?
Do you remember the hood that used to do that and his eyes used to light up? The bald head?
No.
This would be an old...
Of course, I haven't got a hood.
No, I know that. Yeah.
Although you don't drink alcohol, if you two could go on a pub crawl with anyone famous, aside from each other, who would it be?
If I was going to go on a pub crawl, Stephen Hawking.
Well, why? Just because he would go pretty slowly? Why?
I wouldn't let him bring the chair.
You wouldn't let him bring the chair? So he would actually be crawling?
Yeah.
He'd actually be crawling?
Can you just be... It's all right, yeah. Officer. I'll see... I'll see you get home, all right. Somebody said to get on with it.
We were...
This is it? Get on with the Stephen Hawking mime. I want to see what happens when he's been drinking. Show me the way to go home.
If you were stranded on a desert island with three famous people, who would they be? Shall I tell you who I'd be on?
No, yeah, right.
Freddie Mercury.
Yeah,
that wouldn't be much point in that, would that?
Oh, no, he could sing to you.
He's going to make a raft out of him.
Are they dead or alive?
Yeah. Oh,
Marty Pello.
Marty Pello? Fantastic.
Yeah.
Worth getting shipwrecked for, I would have thought. Yeah. Think of the jokes you could do about wet. Yeah. Yeah, and
Leslie Phillips.
Leslie Phillips?
Yeah.
What, the bloke who used to go,
hello? Yeah, just you'd get a bit bored with that, though, wouldn't you?
Yeah, that's all he ever says. Conversation ends there with Leslie.
Well, if I was on a desert island with people who live in the dead, I'd have Isambard Kingdom Brunel.
Jordan.
Obviously.
Yeah.
That would get rid of any fear of drowning. Yes, and who else?
What about Jeff Astor? Yeah.
Well, I'd have that bloke, yeah, definitely. Because his dinner conversation would be so sparkling, I think.
Also, Jeff Astor!
Yes.
Yes. Yes. We fucking earned it. People in fucking New Zealand earned it.
But it'd be very good for calling out to passing ships.
Yeah. Only they were called Jeff Astor.
We're on this desert island! Not many people would come and pick us up,
no, obviously. I shouldn't have imagined.
Yes, and you're fucking staying there, mate. Isn't that Jordan?
All right, Roadrunner.
I think Roadrunner as well.
Yeah, he's
fucking Speedy
fast.
Gonzales, I've never fucking laughed at ever. But the Roadrunner is like one of the... I think it's the best cartoon ever. Ask the question, you mardy-faced cow.
In my experience, one thing that women who've had six cans of Stella do give is a fuck.
But what I wanted to ask was, we want to take you back to the last series.
Oh, I thought you were going to say to your flat for a minute. Yeah.
And in the last series, you mentioned a 42-year-old lady and a reference to walnut whips.
And yes, now, sorry, let me explain, because I'd quite like to pin Frank down on this as well. There was a point where Frank referred to women over about 40, 42-year-old women as having genitals like walnut whips. There's no way she knows what a walnut whip is.
Well, she will in 26 years' time. Anyway. Yes, I did say, it's true I did say this, you know, but on reflection...
Lots, can you see it in the mirror?
Yeah, lots of 42-year-old women have written to me and faxed me.
And how they didn't burn themselves, I'll never know. But I was basing it all on one woman I knew who did, it could be said, have a vagina like a walnut whip.
But with a little nut on the end.
Yeah, me. Anyway, I'm sorry if I offended you. I take it back. I think 42-year-old women, you know, aren't great. Yeah, great grandmas, a lot of them. Well, I'm 44.
I know.
Yeah.
Yeah, you see his genitals. I'm interested in the 25% of men who don't piss in the sink or have never pissed in the sink. I don't believe they exist.
They're dwarves.
Oh, right.
Yeah. So how long have you been going out with Libby, Tim? You know Libby, the girlfriend. Yes. So what...
Easy Tiger.
He's flogging that. Yeah. Yeah.
It's diminishing returns now on Easy Tiger, isn't it?
I get 10 quid for every time I say Easy Tiger.
No.
Yeah. From who?
Yeah.
Esso.
Oh, yes.
Hello. Mikey's asked if you've ever done yoga, and if you haven't, can she show you some moves?
Well, I did have a very sexy yoga teacher. The one time I went to yoga, I had a very sexy yoga teacher, and she used to do all these positions, like say, I am the swan, right, and I am the vole, right, and I was just thinking, I am the tripod. All through it.
Can she show you some moves?
You what?
Can she
show us some moves? Well, I suppose she could. What do you think?
No.
Well, yeah, come on.
Come on up and show us some yoga moves. Come on. Come on.
What's your name?
Lara.
Lara
Croft.
No, it's not Lara Croft, is it? Otherwise, she'd have climbed up there and gone,
ooh.
So, there you go. You've got no shoes on, for goodness sake.
You've fought
your... You've got stilettos.
Well, and what, you just carry them around with you? You don't wear them on, don't wear them on your
women,
feet?
That's what drunken women always do, they carry the shoes.
They don't... Did she hit you? Did she hit you?
Come on, Lara, let's have a move.
All right.
We sit together, OK?
OK?
Yeah?
Right,
we'll
watch it come off, don't worry.
You'll have that.
Yeah? This one?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can I sit there for a bit? Well, I tell you, I've always been very, very fucking partial to Columbo.
Have you?
I could stay in and maybe have 8 episodes of Columbo and watch them one after the next and be perfectly happy.
He had a glass eye, of course, didn't he, Columbo?
That doesn't put me off.
No, I'm not suggesting it should put you off, but that was part of his detection, wasn't it? The fact that he had a glass eye didn't stop him from being a very good detective. And it might do, because if stuff happened on his blind side, he wouldn't notice it.
Yeah, but you see, although the actor had a glass eye, I don't know that Columbo actually had a glass eye.
Raises a very difficult question about reality and fiction.
No, I think all we're saying is in this particular role, the glass eye played the part of a real eye.
Bobby Charlton, Kevin Keegan, and who's the other one?
Chris Waddle.
Well, it does. If you had a choice, what would be your preference for a style of merkin?
A merkin is a pubic wig. Do you mean mullet?
No.
Well, I mean,
what, if I actually had to have a merkin?
You had a merkin, would you have a swipe across Bobby Charlton?
Will I have a mullet Chris Waddle?
Yeah.
Or a curly... Keegan. Well, I've got a bit of Kevin Keegan already, I'm Jewish. Pretty curly down there to begin with.
I imagine
with.
Yours looks more like Ketsubaya. But mine looks like W.H. Auden in his late years.
Yes. Mm. Well, lined.
Oh, very lined.
Right.
Yeah, fleece.
Oh, Oh, I don't know. Chris Waddle would be a very strange shape of merkin because the mullet bit would actually hang down over your over your cock and balls, to be honest.
With a cock and ball story.
Now, the nice thing about that is that when you could be in a room with a young lad you'd met before, you could just separate them like curtains. Yeah.
Wouldn't be the first thing you separated like curtains, obviously.
Steady. It wouldn't be the first thing, surely.
Would it?
Yeah. But you'd open that and it'd make an entrance.
Yeah.
The penis would rise up.
The penis would just come through the curtain.
If I had that, if I had a kind of a curtain effect of pubic hair, I might have a small cassette with me that goes...
Well, you'd do a dance as well.
Yeah, I'd do a dance. Who'd stop me? No one.
No one.
That bloke there, look.
Do you mind if I go for a piss?
I don't want you to come on stage and do that.
I can just piss here if you want.
Let him go. You want to ask those two, not us.
I'll tell you what, if you ask a proper question first, then we'll talk about that and then you can have your piss. Is that a deal?
When you live together, who wore the trousers?
Very good. Well, I'll tell you one thing, I didn't wear the fucking gay pink shirt ever.
Have you ever been gay? That's a very good question.
Have you ever been gay?
Hold on, I'll just check my diary. We did both wear the trousers on one occasion, but we were in pantomime at the time. I was the front of the horse. But it was a reasonable question. I think you can have your piss with some pride. He was a... quite a good-looking bloke, I thought.
What's happened? Has the shirt osmosed into your soul?
Well, yes, it's osmosed into my soul.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Fucking hell.
Yeah, sort of Donny Osmosed. That's what they call me.
Yes, that nice lady there.
With spectacles. Have you got spectacles or is that something?
Can I just say that's my husband, so thank you very much for saying that.
Well, he's a nice-looking bloke. You must have noticed that even in those spectacles. What's his name?
Anthony.
Is there anything you'd like to tell us about Anthony while he's out?
He was actually in the Sea Cadets when he was younger.
What, all of them? He was in the Sea Cadets?
He was in the Sea Cadets, and I've got a video of him playing a drum, but he couldn't actually play it, so he was miming to it. So
he mimed drum in the Sea Cadets?
What woman would you be and why?
If I could be a woman, I would almost certainly be a lesbian. Because I don't like to be fucked by men, generally.
And also, you'd be able to keep your beard.
Yeah.
Do you really ever have really obscure dreams? And if you do, what do you think they mean?
Frank, I can tell you, because it's actually more obscure than any dream I've ever had. Frank once had a dream that he was shagging Virginia Wade. Right? Perhaps you'd like to take up the story.
Yes. A dream I believe I told you about in some confidence. Well, I did. I dreamt I was... if you're watching, Virginia. Virginia Wade, I was having sex with her, and then she turned into a blue perspex pyramid about this high. And you know I didn't stop. Well,
nothing puts you off.
I had this pyramid.
Yeah.
I suddenly thought, where's all the hair gone?
Is she very hairy?
Oh, she's like a horse. Huh? In the dream.
In the dream, yeah.
And I was like this with the pyramid, and I could see my knob inside. Like a sarcophagus.
Like a sarcophagus?
Like a sarcophagus, yes.
How far in did it? It went right into
Well, how far in? What kind of a question is that? You're trying to lead me on to some sort of detail.
How far in to this pyramid?
I'd say it went in about 9.5 inches.
And, did you impregnate the blue perspex pyramid? Is there a blue and salmon little blue pyramid there?
No, because I was actually in the Sphinx. Where are you, the woman who asked that question? What's the strangest dream you've had?
No, I can't say. No.
Oh, come on.
Does it involve Frank?
No, no, I just get drowning dreams.
A drowning
all the time,
one.
Yeah.
Do you get a lot of these?
Yeah, every night.
Every night?
Yeah. Fucking hell.
You want to learn to swim. You want to learn to swim.
And when you're there under the water, are these brown beads? Worth seeing. Yeah. What kind of dreams do you have? Are you a dreamer of sorts?
It's quite sad, really. I dream about cases.
You dream about suitcases, or...?
No, cases that I'm working on and problems that might arise.
So how do you tell the difference in your dream life and your waking life? Because that's just what you do all day.
Well, the dream life, I always win, don't I?
Oh, dear.
Yeah.
Mm. So you're a shit lawyer, then?
Is that libelous, Debbie?
I think it might, but you'll find out shortly.
Okay.
That'd be great, wouldn't it? Have to be taken to court on the West End stage. Yeah. Accused a pupil barrister of being a shit lawyer.
And then she could prove me wrong there and then.
Yeah.
Although if she lost it, I'd be fucking right, wouldn't I? Anyway, he's back. He's back from his piss.
Anthony, thank God you're here.
Thank you, mate.
I was just thinking to myself. Ring any bells? No fucking idea what I'm talking about. They had, what's his name, the head of the Conservative Party?
Yeah, William Hague.
William Hague, yeah.
So he was on the telly today.
He was on the telly.
And someone asked a question, this is what you're going to say.
They asked Fionn a question. They said, are you enjoying the campaign so far? And she went... And he said, yes, she is. She's having a fabulous time.
Yeah, I saw that. You see that on the news? She didn't even have time to go like that. He just leapt in straight away and answered the question for her.
He was afraid she was going to say something.
Yeah, so no, I'm fucking hating it. Got her with a bald cunt. That's what he was worried she was going to say.
I shall scrub it out.
What?
Your mouth.
Thank you.
Well, I was really shocked at that. Presumably she can... I thought, what, has she got a terrible voice? Fionn, what are you thinking of? Like this. It's the motherland! Fucking hell!
Just a geography question, actually.
Geography question?
I wondered, if Russia invaded Turkey from the rear, would Greece help?
That's a fucking Christmas cracker joke, right, isn't it?
Not any Christmas cracker I've ever had.
That's Turkey.
Yeah, okay. I'll let you off for that. Yeah. Well, as a lubricant, I've always found Greece very unsatisfactory.
Have you?
Yeah, especially beef dripping.
Yeah? What do you use normally?
Well, you know, one of the problems is often, say if you're in a hotel room, all you've got is the hotel moisturiser.
Yes.
It was often quite a short man. And the trouble is with the moisturiser is eventually it rubs in.
Yes.
You have to keep applying.
Right.
It's a bit like lathe operating.
I would have thought someone like you would carry emergency Vaseline.
I've never used Vaseline ever.
Haven't you?
No. Have you?
Yeah.
Have you? Truly you are something of a traditionalist.
When I first got what I believe is called my brown wings, and as a former sea cadet, you'll know what I mean. You know, I thought that's what you had to get.
Vaseline.
Well, you're looking at me like that's ridiculous. But...
Well, no, I mean, I never thought anyone really used it. I thought that was a kind of a playground howler.
Well, what do you use?
If you use nothing, you often get a playground howler.
Hello.
We've heard a lot of Tim talking, but can he write?
Such a good point, mate.
It's a very good point. I noticed that,
it's
mate.
A very good point.
Yeah, you're supposed to be logging the evening, as it were.
Paralysed.
I'll say Tim.
Tim.
Well, hey.
Tim, you're meant to be sort of jotting down notes about what we're saying. On that.
Do you remember?
Paralysis says everything, really.
Do you know where you are?
Paralysis says everything.
Do you get Jewish gingies?
I don't know, actually. I think you can get, yeah. Hey, there's one up there.
A Jewish ginger.
You are.
Do you have a ginger capel to sort of match it off? If you had a brown cap, you'd look a bit like a Jaffa cake. Isn't Jaffa in Israel?
Jaffa is in Israel, yeah.
There you go,
yeah.
Jaffa in Israel.
Oh, it's all wheels within wheels.
Maybe a Jaffa kike.
This is a request for Frank. Could you sing Happy Birthday to my friend Catherine in the style of Elvis Costello? Hey!
Can I sing Happy Birthday to your friend Catherine?
We're basically children's entertainers, aren't we?
I wish we'd brought the balloon.
Yeah, well, they are.
In the style
of... There you go, it's written up. Elvis Costello.
How do I say?
Do you want to do
it
that?
It actually says Elvis Costello.
Well, that's how Tim would pronounce it.
He's a lovely chap, mate.
That's what the bloke who does my laundry calls him.
Fabulous. In this day and age, to have a Chinese laundryman joke is marvellous. It really is.
Anyway, I'll do it if you like.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Catherine. Happy birthday to you.
Marvellous. Okay. That lady there.
Yes,
the
lady on the aisle.
Hello.
Hello.
What, on the baby aisle?
Yes.
What do you think about the new improved panty liners? Well, you can get both black panty liners now, plus G-string panty liners with wings. What do you think?
With brown wings?
Yeah.
I suppose on a bad night.
You can get a G-string in your panty liner. Yeah, I think someone brought this
now
up.
Now you get a panty liner in your G-string. Not a G-string in your panty liner. What, like some sort of free gift?
Yeah.
No, I think a panty liner is the big one, isn't it?
No, it's the thin one. It's for, like, everyday purposes.
For everyday purposes?
Yeah.
You're going to bloody bleed to death. So it's not for period things?
No, it's for...
What the...
It's for discharge.
It's for discharge.
Discharge.
Is it for discharging someone from the sea cadets?
Oh dear. Do you get specially fit ones for a dishonourable discharge? Now you see, I'd have thought the problem with the G-string on a panty liner is it looks a bit like Father Christmas with a chin strap. Well, are these the ones I've seen on the telly where women wear pants until about midday and then they put in a new gossip?
Yeah.
Is that the one?
It's like you have fresh knickers at the end of the day after work.
Yeah, that's
it's
a good
handy.
Idea, I think.
What would you do?
What do they do with the old gossip?
Put it down the toilet.
Okay.
Well, that can't be environmentally safe, can it? The sea will be full of old gussets. And Jordan will be swimming past and try and wear them.
Yeah, sea cadets will be here. What I'd be inclined to do is, if I worked in an office which was relatively private, when I took out the one at about 3 o'clock in the afternoon, I'd just slam it up the wall. And by, say, 2 or 3 months, the office would be completely soundproof.
Would you stand on cloning?
Where do I stand on cloning?
Well, if you're going to be cloned, mate, then I'm very against it.
Well, I've always thought that they were not very funny and a little bit frightening.
No, that's...
That's clowning.
Clowns, yeah.
Oh, shit. Do you like it or not?
I think it brings out the feminine side in you.
It brings out the feminine side in me.
Oh, right.
Mark, that's yeah, lovely. Actually, I've got fucking moody since I put it on.
People aren't sure about the shirt. You've got to ask
What the
about
fucking
it.
Hell do you mean by that? That's fucking typical of you, isn't it? People aren't sure about this and people aren't sure about that. Well, I know what you're fucking sure about. Hey, you were sure about that fucking barmaid last night? Don't fucking clap me. Don't fucking clap me.
What woman is it that sits like this?
Every fucking woman in the world.
Really?
Women, whenever they're telling you off, right, and they're in a bad mood, they seem to have their script on a computer screen going on the left somewhere. So they say, oh, well, that's fucking great, isn't it? Oh, no, you just do what you like, aren't you? Hey, girls, I love you, really.
Let's have a question from that lady there.
My brother tells me that you're a big Elvis fan, and so are we, and you apparently bought a shirt that belonged to him. Do yes. you wear it?
I don't wear it. It's blue velvet's not really my colour. No, I do. I get it. It's actually, I bought it. I paid 11 grand for this shirt, Elvis's shirt. And it's...
That's nothing to you, is it?
No, it's nothing. I spend that on a good cigar.
Yeah.
I use it, I garden in it. And I got it and I thought, fantastic, got Elvis's shirt, fantastic. And I got it home and I put it in the wardrobe and I thought, yes. And it's been there for 2 years.
Yeah.
And I occasionally go and have a look at it, but what can you do with it, really?
What you did do with it is you wore it on one TV show and then claimed the 11 grand against tax.
That's true.
There.
You're a North London Jew, so you yeah. must support Tottenham or Arsenal.
No, the thing is, right, a lot of people think that I must, because I'm Jewish, I must support Arsenal or Tottenham, but the fact is, I'm Jewish, not a fucking twat, right?
Objection. he is a fucking twat.
Oh, okay.
Shall I note that down?
Is that overruled or sustained?
Sustained.
Sustained. I like the way you started by saying, David, you're a North London Jew. In case you'd forgotten.
Actually, you came out yesterday. Came out yesterday and this...
You came out yesterday?
I did, yes.
I should. Do you want a bottle of this?
And there were some people at the stage door and someone said to me, I was going to ask you a question. She said, I'd like to ask you, what kind of Jew are you? What, a dirty Jew? What did she mean?
What kind of Jew are you?
Yeah. What kind of Jew
Morning are you? Morning Jew.
Morning Jew is
Morning
very good.
Jew. Jew drop.
Jew on.
Jew on.
Jew on.
Jew on. It's a period joke. Not as a period drama.
But I see. Jew on. It's very, yeah.
Overdue.
Overdue? Yeah. Actually, if I was overdue, I'd be like this. Overdue.
What would you be like?
Ding, 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 ding. I don't know why I made that fucking noise, all right? I tried to make a sort of Jewish noise and it went really wrong.
Yeah, no, it's like a fucking disabled bus conductor. Ding, 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 ding.
Disabled bus conductor?
Move down the front. Ding, 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 ding.
Yes.
Is there a curry hash out here?
Fucking hell, that's coming out of my head.
Where are you?
I'm here.
Oh, right. Oh, it's
Is
it's
there
Mandy.
A curry house around here? I'm not actually a Pakistani. I know a lot of people think I am, but I don't know that. I'm not actually. You're looking for a curry and you ended up in here. Can we do it, chicken corner?
Was it the red velvet upholstery that threw you?
Would you like to do the show that Richard and Judy have been doing?
Would we like
to take over Richard and Judy?
Well, I'm getting very fat and I think I may have the tits for it quite soon.
I think. But I don't know, which one would be which?
I really respect...
You're the older woman. Aren't you, really?
Now, I really respect Richard and Judy, the way they do that thing and they say, well, anyway, Enid, thank you for talking to us about your ovarian cysts. Now, how to make the perfect Christmas pudding. To be able to switch like that is really something special. So I'd like to give it a go. I mean, I don't think they'd have two men doing it, would they? It would be the best replacement, do you think?
I don't know.
Posh and Beck's a bit, if they, I mean, obviously couldn't really get... No, I'd watch it, I'd watch Posh and Beck's.
I think, I believe they use auto-cue on Richard and Judy, so... Well, it's basically a programme for housewives and students who can't be bothered to fucking do anything. That's what they should cover, really. Really, they should have on a housewife's favourite, like Delia Smith, and Neil from The Young Ones.
Neil from The Young Ones is a student's favourite.
Well, he's a student.
And I'm the old guy.
Oh, hello.
But,
Oh, dear. You all right back there? That's Tim
no,
molested
boys,
you anyway.
I'm busting for a gypsies. Do you mind? It's okay.
You're busting for a gypsies?
A gypsy. A gypsy Lee.
That's tea, isn't it? Not a piss.
Yeah. That is tea. You're busting for some tea.
Tea?
Well, that'd be nice as well, yeah.
That'd be nice as well. Yeah. You're busting for a piss and you want a cup of tea. That's very unusual.
Don't you? Doesn't the outfit come with a bedpan?
Sadly not.
You can go for a piss if you want to.
Is that okay?
Well, sure? Can you leave the equipment? Don't take the mic with you, for God's sake.
I need to ask a question that's not been asked before to each other. What would it be?
If I had to ask a question of Dave that he's never been asked before.
Have you ever fucked one of my girlfriends? I've wanted to ask that for a while. I'm glad you gave me the option.
If you're invisible for one night only, which famous celebrity would you shag?
I don't know if you could shag someone. I thought you were going to say, would you creep into their bedroom? But if you were invisible and you shagged them, they'd get very frightened. What's going to fuck? They'd get terrible.
But if you followed home, say, Anne Garrard Rees.
Who's that?
The actress.
I don't know who that is.
Well, any sexy actress. Who's a sexy actress?
Vanessa Feltz.
Okay. If you followed home...
Vanessa Feltz, right?
And you went into her bedroom and she got down to just maybe jockey briefs.
Yes.
If you were invisible and you started masturbating.
Yes.
When you ejaculated, would that be invisible as well?
Well, no. If I'd wanked four or five times that day.
Can we keep it to masturbate? We've got a 16-year-old schoolgirl on stage.
Well, as I say, if I'd ejaculated a lot that day, then it would almost definitely be invisible.
But if it was your first of the day, unlikely, I know.
Yes. it's an evening time you're talking about,
well, maybe
it?
If you overslept.
Well,
would it be invisible?
Are you asking if bodily fluids are invisible if you're invisible? That's what you're asking.
I suppose that is what I'm asking, in a nutshell.
Yes.
Okay. It would be a shocker if Vanessa couldn't see her and suddenly there was sperm in the air as it got.
What would she think? A Roman candle had suddenly gone off in her room?
No.
Well, she might do.
Well, could she possibly think that? She'd think, I finally
Well,
got
she
that.
Wouldn't fucking think an invisible bloke's in here wanking.
She'd probably think, oh, that spot must have finally gone. Besides,
if you were invisible, would you...
Oh, if you were invisible.
Would you do that thing of wrapping bandages round yourself and then cutting out eyes or whatever?
Well, that would be ridiculous, because then you'd be seen, almost certainly.
In every invisible film I've seen, that's what they end up doing. I don't know if they're injured. But they always end up wrapping bandages around themselves.
The trouble is, as they got dirty, those blokes, you'd be able to see them anyway, wouldn't you?
Yeah, that's true.
Otherwise,
yeah.
You'd be able to smell them, and if you couldn't smell them, that would mean they had deodorant on, and then you'd be able to see, like, two white patches moving around. Yeah. Doesn't make any sense. Maybe, you know, sometimes you just get a little bit of toilet paper stuck to your bum.
Yeah.
That'd be like, ooh, yes. Hold on.
More people think that. They would think it was a bit of pollen.
Yeah, you'd be covered in bees in no time. Anyway, another fine question. Who would you follow home?
It'd have to be you, Frank,
obviously.
It'd
be me?
You can just come home anyway. Yes, mate.
What do you think should be done with Wembley Stadium?
Wembley
I'll
Stadium?
I'll tell you one thing, I don't think it should go to fucking Birmingham. Just, you know. Who wants it to go there, really? You'd have to go to Birmingham, for a start, to see things.
I have to say, I think it should definitely be in Birmingham.
Why is that?
Well, for a start-off, there'd be less Londoners going to England games, and that'd mean less trouble.
Yeah. It would only cost £5 to build. Just because it's in the middle of the fucking country, we can't have the National Stadium in a shithole.
Have you never sat at an England game and thought to yourself, fucking Londoners, eh? What horrible right-wing, drunken, violent, skinhead people they are.
Well, to be honest with you, I've never been in Birmingham and thought, what sophisticates they are.
Did you have any input with regards to the caricatures at the back? And if so...
Well, we provided the faces.
But, very devilish in it as well. Your eyebrows are very devilish.
But the ears look like they're on back to front. That's the worrying thing. You know what I mean? You know, they haven't got any of the whirlpool things that ears have. I went to... In fact, we both went to Jonathan Ross's This Is Your Life. You know, This Is Your Life obviously is recorded live and they cut lots of stuff out. And Gary Lineker came on and I don't think Jonathan would mind me telling
you. No, he wouldn't mind.
Gary Lineker said in a very nice, jovial way, you know, he said to Michael Aspel, he said, can I just say, it's great to be on a TV show with Jonathan where you can get a word in edgeways. And Jonathan said, shut up, you jug-eared cunt.
Do you know, I think we should definitely put that in the video.
I did one of them tour things on the Thames. You know, you take a boat up the Thames. And the bloke on there was a bit of a cockney geezer. And he said, we're now passing Cheyne Walk in Chelsea. The home of many famous people. James McNeil Whistler, the painter. George Bernard Shaw, the writer. And Oscar Wilde, the puff. Honestly.
Did he say that?
Honestly,
that
I swear.
Is brilliant.
Okay, now this is the bit where we close with a song. I'm going to ask the bloke it's here with Simon. The cap on, who's had a cap on all show. I'd like you to pick... what have you got? Is that fashion or chemotherapy? I'll tell you...
Oh, fuck off! It is chemotherapy now.
He's off to Disneyland the weekend. What's he care? It isn't chemotherapy, is it? It fucking isn't. Exactly, you liar. I could see a bit of hair. I'm a pro. To the fucking fingertips, my friend. And the bloke with that... Is that Japanese, that T-shirt you've got on there?
Yeah.
Yeah? Would you pick a number, mate, between 1 and 10?
7.
7, OK. It's Crocodile Rock. And make it snappy. You know, I often thought it would have been better if you'd have done that at Diana's funeral. That other one was very maudlin, I thought. Maybe I'm still standing.
Someone's put the guitar music here and not piano music.
Now,
Frank, I'll have a go, but I'll fuck it up.
Have you not got a guitar?
No. I'll have a go.
Just have a quick practice.
That'll do. That'll do. No, fuck off, that'll do.
Les Dawson, ladies and gentlemen.
Beautiful. She may be the face I can't forget. What are you fucking laughing at? I'd love to see Charles Aznavour to that, wouldn't you? Oh, what are you fucking laughing at, you fucking cunts?
an intro. I did, ages ago.
Well,
there goes my baby with someone new. She sure looks happy. I sure am blue.
It's written by a Smurf.
She may be the mirror of my dream, a smile reflected in a stream. She may not be what she may seem inside her shell.
Hold on.
She's a fucking tortoise, apparently.
Hold on, two...
Charles Aznavour went out with a tortoise.
Two pages of this are stuck together.
Pages are stuck... Yeah. It's a very exciting song.
Okay.
I actually know the words.
That's just...
She may be so happy in a cloud. No, this is the mid-light. The mid-light.
I haven't got the mid-light.
Just bear with me. I'll do the mid-light really quickly, a cappella, and then come back for the closing thing.
All right.
When I say a cappella, I don't mean Stranger on the Shore, for any old reason. She may be so happy in a crowd, those eyes may be so private and so proud. No one's allowed to see them when they cry. She may be the love I cannot hope to last, may come to me from the shadows of the past, but I'll remember to the day I die.
All right.
She may be the reason I survive, the why I wherefore I'm alive, the one I'll care for through the rough and rainy. When Rock was young, me and Susie had so much fun. Just a minute. Who's out judge on the kid with the me and Susie line? And he's in Crocodile Rock. Isn't that just fucking Cockney rhyming slang? I have found a new love, dear.
Now that's wrong, isn't it?
Wrong.
If you're dumping someone, you don't say, I found a new love, dear. You say, I found a new love, pig face.
But the biggest kick I ever got was doing a thing called the Crocodile Rock. While the other kids were rocking round the clock, we were hopping and a bopping to the Crocodile Rock. They're rocking to something shocking when your feet just can't keep still. I never had me a better time, and I guess I never will. Call mama, it was Friday night when Susie wore her dresses that you did. I'm cooking in the rocking, I was out of sight.
No, no, this is the bit that goes dun 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 dun.
It goes la.
What do I miss most about being in Birmingham?
Is it the outside toilets?
Now they've got inside toilets.
Have they?
They have got
but
inside toilets.
But your dad, is this not correct, thought it was unhygienic to have an indoor toilet. That's true.
But that's essentially right, isn't it? It's essentially true. If you started building houses now from scratch, and someone said to you, you were an alien and you arrived and you were going to build a house, and they said, now... One thing that people do is they shit, right? They just shit into a big pile of water. Shall we put that inside the house or outside the house? You'd say, well, obviously not inside the fucking... You don't want that in the house. You'd have it outside. So there was a logic to that. So yeah. I do miss that, but there's lots of indoor toilets in Birmingham now.
Are there?
Yeah.
The NEC.
And also, I asked for a...